having a crazy Sunday morning with the babies, but my husband made some homemade sauerkraut a couple of weeks ago, and it's ready, and I figured I'd can it up. He liked it. I haven't tried it yet. There's something about a recipe that requires you to skim the scum off the top that I just can't quite get on board with yet, but he loved it, and so I'm going to can it up because there's quite a bit left over. My suggestion so far is don't do your sauerkraut on a day when you might have company or when you might have company the next day or possibly even the next, because let me tell you, it's smelling up my entire house. But it was previously smelling up the entire downstairs fermenting, so it's been a while with stinky sauerkraut house. I've got everything laid out here. I've got my rings. I'm going to do regular mouth jars. I've got all my canning tools laid out, and I've got a new toy that I'm going to try out today. I just found this. I actually found it online first, and I got it from Williams-Sonoma, which is on board with canning now, which I find interesting. But it's got, if you can see, it's got headspace markers here, because I am really bad with this tool at figuring out how much headspace there is. So I'm going to give this funnel a try today. It works for, you can see there's a ring on the inside for regular mouth, or it'll use the outside for wide mouth. Okay, so I've got my sauerkraut. It's been simmering back here. The ball canning book says don't bring it to a boil, so I haven't. It's just on simmer. I've got my jars all ready to go here. And on the other side of the canning pot, I have my lids in simmering water waiting for me too. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get started filling up these jars. According to the ball canning book, I want to fill them leaving a half an inch of headspace. And then I'm going to ladle some liquid over the top of the sauerkraut and remove the air bubbles, put the caps on, and I'm going to process them for, these are quart jars, so I'm going to process them for 20 minutes. Okay, so let me get started. Interesting. It's going to give me a little bit of trouble, I think. It's so dense, just getting it through that funnel is a little bit of a challenge, but we adapt. That's what we do, right? In the prepping world, we adapt. I do really think I'm going to like this new funnel. So far, so good. I was worried about how easy it would be to read as it sat on the bottle, but it seems okay. You can hear my crazy kids in the background. I apologize, but if I didn't get this done today, it wasn't going to get done. And I usually do things in nap time intervals, but that just didn't happen today. Okay, so I think we're about, if you can see, here's the half inch mark. I think I'm going to put another ladle full in, and then I'm going to put some liquid on top. There we go. Here's the half inch, or that's a quarter inch. Here's the half inch mark. Looks good to me. And now for the liquid. And I'm making a terrible mess, which is usually the way things go. liquid. And now we're good. Oh, almost did it. It's like you get so into what you're doing and you just want to get it in that canner that you forget to wipe the lid, to wipe the rim there. I do it almost every time. But I felt better the other day when I was watching one of the Mrs. Volpe's videos, and she did the same thing, and I remember sitting there going, oh no, you forgot to wipe the lid. But she went back and did it, of course. But it's nice to know that even the pros make mistakes, do the same things we do, we newbies. All right, so finger tight. And off it goes to sit in my canner and hang out until I can get the others going. Okay, so, I did get 4 jars, so that's good, and I'm going to go ahead and drop them down and process them for 20 minutes once it comes up to a boil. So I'll be back when they're done. So here's the finished product, 4 quarts. They all came out bubbling and boiling, and that makes me happy, so just going to wait around for the happy ping sound that we all know and love. Any questions, comments, concerns, feedback, constructive criticism, I am more than happy to hear from you. So please send me a message. Happy prepping!